I have found a new muse, discovered a new profession. Aged curio, the last of a dying breed.
Doesn't it make you tired? I mean,
do not worry, Mr. Steele, it won't kill me. A few performances every now and then.
Well, I suppose not.
And a feature film in England.
A feature film in England.
How can I refuse? And gardens in perpetuity, but on one condition. Do not age, do not wither, do not grow old. Even a marriage to oneself cannot last forever. My body and I divorced years ago, but we're still forced to live together.
You're tired. No more performances.
Mr. Steele says that I should stop performing. He says we're fighting old battles.
Okay, fine. If you feel like you don't have anything more to say, you can go home and I'll do the show myself.
Oh, yes. Once you have decided you are a stylist, you must keep your eye on the ultimate horizon, your finale. A way of ending it on your own terms. Otherwise, you'll find yourself on an iron bedstead in a rented room with people standing around you saying, "He can't last much longer."
That's an asshole!
I wish you'd stop doing that.
Yes, that would not be a good way to go. Gunned down by a policeman. That'd be dying in style. Shot through the heart by a member of the NYPD.
You're incredible.
People ask me what I would like played at my funeral. They imagine that we can look down from a cloud and count the number of mourners at our wake. And we won't. We'll be dead. When I die, I don't care what happens. To me or to the world.
Mm-hmm. What do you want to do with these?
Invitations to parties, picture galleries, film premieres, all must be attended to.
Or you could just throw them away.
Won't they be angry?
No, they won't.
How will I live?
Oh, Quentin, you have over $1 million in your savings account.
It is possible to put quite a bit by if you're prepared to live on peanuts and champagne.
Come on. Throw them away. Amphar. AIDS research.
I send them checks because it has long been an ambition of mine to meet Miss Taylor.
You sent Amphar thousands of dollars just so you can meet Elizabeth Taylor. And for no other reason.
None at all.
Uh-huh. I'll mail it for you.
Please don't bother. Housework is a mistake.
Well, then, let me make a mistake on your behalf.
Why? It'll only raise 2 decades worth of dust.
It's really not healthy, and you're not well anyhow.
He who so famously said that after the first 4 years the dust doesn't get any worse, he was wrong. The dust took its awful revenge. Mr. Steele, why are you so determined to save me from myself?
Because, Mr. Crisp, you are important to me.
How so?
When they showed the naked civil servant on cable, I was still in the closet, living in Hicksville, Kentucky, and they showed that film and...
The film again.
Yes, 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 that film again. They showed the film and I saw what you did, how you braved them out, and it changed my life. I moved to New York, I started to live. And that would not have been possible if it hadn't been for you. And this is the filthiest stove I have ever seen. Oh. What is it? You all right? What is it?
Amongst other conditions, I have a hernia. And I don't think I'm wearing the support correctly. Philip.
Quentin,
Allow me to introduce you to something called broccoli.
You can't go back to England.
Why not?
You have an enlarged heart, psoriasis all over your body, and you're in remission from a bout of prostate cancer that you're not telling anyone about. A transatlantic flight would not be a good idea right now. Let me go with you.
That would get me into trouble with my employers.
You don't need the money. 7 hours in a pressurized cabin. Your heart is never going to take it. Oh, I get it. Suicide by airplane, huh? I don't want you to die.
Why not?
You're too important. It looks like they're going to elect another Bush. I mean, you said things would get worse. You didn't say they'd get this bad. I'm not exactly selling the idea of continuing to live here, am I?
No.
Well, then fine. I hope you die on the plane. That way, England will have to bear all of the expenses and have none of the profits.
Wouldn't that be wonderful?
What does Steele say?
Mr. Steele is cozy.
I can't leave you alone for a second. I thought you weren't going to do any more. You don't have to die in England. You hate England.
Yes, I do. But there'll be so little fuss. I'm almost forgotten there. Here, there is just the possibility that someone will try and rescue me at the last. Before that, my American swan song. I've been invited to do one last question and answer session.
Where is it?
In a gay club in Tampa, Florida.
Do you want to do it?
If only to find out why they want me to. Since I was 19. What will I say to them?
The usual, I imagine.
Persistence is your greatest weapon. It is in the nature of barriers that they fall. Do not seek to become like your opponents. You have the burden and the great joy of being outsiders. Every day you live is a kind of triumph. This you should cling on to. You should make no effort to try and join society. Stay right where you are. Give your name and serial number and wait for society to form itself around you. Because it most certainly will. Neither look forward where there is doubt, nor backward where there is regret. Look inward and ask not if there is anything outside that you want, but whether there is anything inside that you have not yet unpacked.
Englishman in New York. You see me walking down Fifth Avenue, walking cane here at my side. Take it everywhere I walk. I'm an Englishman in New York.